Hello class, good morning to all. Today we are going to start with new chapter of your midterm syllabus and the chapter is Ethics and Safety Measures in Computing. Let's begin the chapter with knowing about what is Internet Service Provider. So nothing but the organization that delivers the internet facility to the users is known as Internet Service Provider. Now we will discuss about how internet is advantageous to us. Very much known by all of us that internet plays most important part in our daily life. Even this virtual communication happening between us is because of internet only. It's helping me to share this chapter explanation with you, whereas it's helping you to receive this chapter explanation from me. So many people are working from home with the common network associated because of internet only. It provides us entertainment like videos, music, cartoon, among various platforms, as well as help us to build connectivity among people we know as well through Facebook, WhatsApp, Instagram, etc. Not just that, but it helps us to send and receive our formal or can say official notification on Gmail. People are also running online business these days with the help of internet connectivity, where they sell their goods and services, for example, Myntra, Amazon, Flipkart, etc. But every coin has two sides that goes with internet as well. So now we are going to discuss about some disadvantages of internet. With this fast running life of internet, we often forget about what physical interaction means with people, because chatting with our friends and relatives became so easy and quick that now we have physically distanced ourselves from them and cut out meeting them in personally. Secondly, because we have now got online store of almost everything, we have almost left going to market. Also, we have got so many options and things in online stores that sometime we end up buying even those things that are not required at all, which is a waste of money. For entertainment purpose as well, we find so many games and videos etc. on internet that we totally skipped outdoor games and fun. Sadly, our life has somehow compacted in this unreal virtual world called internet. So by knowing these pros and cons of internet, what can we do to balance both? The solution is simple, and that is you need to know the limit of doing and using everything. There should be a balance between internet life and real life. Coming to the next topic, that deals with behavior of, or rather say, ethics while using computer. In our daily life, we should follow some rules and regulations, as well as when we use the computer, we should also follow some rules and regulations. This is called ethics while using computer. The principles that governs individual and group on what behavior is acceptable while using computer is known as ethics. Cyber deal with something that is happening through internet network. We will learn about cyber ethics in this segment. So cyber ethics and basically the laws which are formed to obey online behaviors when somebody does not follow them and disobey these laws to harass other people with their personal information or secure official information, then that is called cyber bullying. Now we will know about how these cyber disobedience prevail. So the first is acceptance. Because the content that is being shared on internet is open for all, that mean worldwide, hence we should be aware of what kind of content and services we are sharing online. Second is sensitivity to national and local culture. It is open and being spread nationwide and will be seen by people of all culture rather than one local culture. So content should be according to that and should not hurt anybody's sentiments. Third is using email and chatting. This is very important that the messages we send and receive should be among people we know and not to the stranger. Fourth is pretending someone else. We should be real with our identity on the internet rather than pretending to be someone else. Fifth, avoid bad language. I think it is simple to understand, just like in physical world, we are being taught not to use any sort of offensive language. Same goes to the virtual or the internet world as well. Sixth, hide personal information. We should not send our personal information like house number, mobile number or any photograph or password to any stranger on internet for safety purpose. Seventh, while downloading, we should entertain ourselves from internet, not should never share somebody copyrighted material are basically those which are developed by someone's intellect, hence they claim full right on it and nobody else. Now let's continue with the next topic of this chapter. This is ethical use of the computer user. These rules are very simple to understand and adapt. Like, do not use computer to harm anyone. Now you be thinking, how can you can harm someone by the computer? So the answer is by abusing that person or by spreading false statement on that person, you can actually harm that person. Second is, if you are using someone's computer, it is very important that you do see or check their personal information, as well as without getting the permission, do not open any sort of file that belong to them. Next is, all the products that have copyright labeled on them should be used without the creator's permission. We should respect the law and policy of copyright content. We should not interfere into anybody's privacy, their secure documents or password or anything. One more very important thing to take care about is that we should complain about any offensive or threatening thing that come across while using computer. We should never try to get the password, document or anything from anybody's computer. Next topic is very important to know about. It will tell you about all unethical practices that are happening in the computer. First is data plagiarism. Plagiarism is basically when you copy someone's academic content from the internet. It is something very commonly seen on internet these days among students. Second is cyber bullying. When you bully somebody through electronic technology like text, social media, chat, website, etc. Third is hacking. Hacking is basically trespass into somebody's computer to get access to their secured information. The person who performs such task is called hacker. Hacking can be done ethically as well. So let's know what is ethical hacking. When it is done to protect the weakness in the computer system with the written permission of the owner, then that is called ethical hacking. Next is phishing. These are basically the mail that will direct you to the website that will ask you about your personal information like password or PIN number maybe. Like this, they steal all the information of the user Now next is spamming. Spamming is basically the same mail that have been sent to thousands of people for some fraudulent person or purpose. Next is computer privacy. The protection of private data and communications when get interfered, then they fall in computer privacy. Next is right to privacy. It is the right given by law to each and every computer user to have their own personal space. If anybody try to violate this right of any user, then the user have a right to complain against him or her. Next, software piracy. Software privacy. When somebody illegally copy or distribute any copyrighted software, then that is completely unacceptable. To protect software from such fraud, the end user license agreement is being included in the software. Next is intellectual property right. When someone creates something from their own intelligence, then they have full right on that creation. This is simply called intellectual property right. If you violate this right of the creator, then that will be termed as theft, as violation of such rights are seriously taken. To you should avoid such violation completely. They are illegal to do because by doing so you are disrespecting and misusing the internet or intellect and hard worker or the creator. So class, here I am ending this lecture. We will learn more about this chapter in part 2. Till then, keep keep revising this chapter till here. Thank you. Take care of you.